are the gardener here, and about 3 weeks ago, I redid my front bed, and I want to share with you the progress. Here we have bicolor iris, daylilies, and zinnias, as well as wandering Jew. So things that you do this weekend include weeding and deadheading spent blossoms. But as we can see here, the zinnias have taken well to being transplanted due to the generous rain from the past couple weeks, and I would like to think I had a hand in it myself. My daily leaves look like they are greening up. I'm not sure if I want to add fertilizer yet. I'm not sure if I want to cut back the wandering Jew, because I'm sure they're not going to flower this close to winter. But we'll see. Oh, if you look here closely, you can see how this daylily has divided. If I was to dig up these roots, this would be two. If I was to dig up these roots, that would be two separate plants, and I could transplant one to a different site. Pretty cool. Same thing with this particular daylily as well. Next, we have Dor Plumbago, Mums, Fall Aster, and more Mums. The Mums look pretty crappy, but I assure you they are taken to the soil well. Most plants go through shock after being transplanted. And in order to keep your plant stable throughout shock, you'll have to water them well. Mums require a lot of water, and I'm very lazy, so they're just going to have to get it when they get it. Luckily, they understand this and are abiding. How do I know? Next to the dead blossom, you'll see a fresh blossom. So what I'll also do this weekend is come by, deadhead the mums, so that they can go ahead and start making new sprouts and weed this garden. Some of the plants here, I'm not sure if I want to pull them up or not. For example, here and here. Last year I planted mums in the exact same spot, and perhaps when I overturned the dirt, some root was left behind and now it's sprouting. But what I will pull up is the Bermuda grass and whatever this happens to be. The grass is doing great. The oleander is doing fine. The plumbago is also doing well. The zinnias will be deadheaded. The zinnias will be deadheaded. So will the mums here. And the zinnias are doing well. They will be a deadhead as well. I think I'll develop a fondness for zinnias because they transplant really great and don't require a whole lot of water. Now, sometimes if you water from above, you'll notice that the pretty green leaves you want on your zinnias kind of turn into the fungus infection we see here. Zinnias don't like to get their leaves wet and will respond just so. So if you water from above, try to do it early in the morning so that the water has plenty of chance to evaporate and burn off as the day goes on. Here we have Dor Plumbago. Here's a sprout from the mother plant coming up, which I will not pull up, but I will pull up whatever this is, and I'll pull up this Bermuda grass. Next up is a globe amaranth. I like this. It's very drought tolerant and colorful. You can see we have the magenta, we got the purple tip, and the white, and it's white here. Oh. Last but not least, there are other plants here that I'm not going to pull up either. This Mexican petunia, and I suspect these may also as well be either zinnias or mums from leftover from last season. I planted some bulbs here last spring as well. I thought I'd pull them all up, but I suspect that these are the result of those bulbs. So perhaps I'll let them grow and see what happens. All right, y'all. Thank you so much.
this trip to Garden Grove. Smell like a Lou Dog inside the van.